Hello and welcome to Community Chats. I'm Ali Hammer, and today we're joined with Teresa Dang, a campus recruiter from AWS. Teresa, welcome back to the show. To begin, what can a candidate expect in an AWS interview?
Yeah, depending on the role that you are applying for. So this could range from, you know, live coding tests or, you know, technical questions, but mainly will be based, you know, on our leadership principles. So, you know, definitely encourage, you know, our applicants to really think about, you know, your transferable soft skills. And, you know, the STAR methodology is definitely key. So STAR standing for situation, task, action, result, and reflection. The interviews will typically last around 45 minutes to 1 hour. So don't be surprised as the interviewer will be typing up notes during, you know, the interview, especially if it's a virtual one.
Thanks, Teresa. And as a recruiter here at Amazon, I'm sure you've seen it all. So what kind of tips can you give our audience on succeeding in an AWS interview?
Yeah, definitely read through our Amazon leadership principles. I don't think I can harp on enough about that, as a lot of the questions will be based around that. But it's not all about the principles, but everything that incorporates in an interview. So body language is really important. So it really shows, you know, your motivation in the role. So this could be, you know, from your posture, you know, your hand gestures, you know, eye contact, you know, intonation, but also your pace, you know, when you're answering a question. This can convey on either being nervous, you know, confident, not motivated for the role, or show, you know, if you are actively listening. I would encourage applicants to be professional, but also, you know, be yourself. You know, at Amazon, we definitely encourage everyone to bring their true, authentic self to work. So please be authentic and, you know, be yourself. It's quite easy for hiring managers to, you know, see when you aren't being yourself or spot that out. When going for an Amazon interview, remember any key metrics of, you know, what you've done and your achievements. You know, we are a very data-driven company and everything we do is based from data. So definitely make yourself stand out from, you know, a good interview to an amazing interview. You know, also to note, you know, a lot of interviews are virtual now, so it's easy to type things up or, you know, read on screen. However, you know, and interviewer can also see that, you know, when you're reading, you know, word for word. So try to avoid, you know, and making sure that you practice, you know, your questions or practice your answers. You know, try to prepare by, you know, Googling maybe common interview questions to start off with and you know, go from there.
Those are some awesome tips. And honestly, like data-driven, absolutely. Back up everything you say with an example. And LPs, those are two tips that I can, you know, say that help me for sure. Thanks so much, Teresa. And how can a candidate go about looking for an internal graduate position? Do they just Google it or do they go on campus? Like, where do they even find out about these opportunities?
Yeah. So, you know, if you are, you know, one of those lucky people who know exactly what they want to do in the future, that is absolutely amazing. You know, but often applicants don't know what, you know, or how much time is involved even before, you know, you start applying for that potential job. So if you're one of those people who have no idea, which, you know, I was, I really encourage you to really sit down, you know, and do maybe a strengths and weaknesses exercise. You know, what do you really enjoy? You know, what do you least enjoy? You know, what are you happy to learn or, you know, build your skills on? The strengths and weaknesses will really help you, you know, when you start reading, you know, job descriptions, you know, start to pin down the type of roles that you want to apply for. The last thing that you want to do is apply, you know, for the sake of applying and, you know, you have no interest, you know, from the get-go for that role. Next thing before you make those applications is, you know, really perhaps be involved in, like, you know, with the university, you know, speak to, you know, the local team that will be able to help you with your CV writing or, you know, student societies. You know, there are plenty of universities and student societies that would hold, you know, networking events, you know, so it's your chance to really speak to the people, you know, who work in these companies at these networking events and understand the type of work that they do. If they can't answer, they'll also recommend you to someone who'll be able to answer, you know, your question. So, you know, that research piece is, you know, definitely key, and to remember to be open to, I guess, you know, any doors or opportunities presented to you. So you never know, you know, if you say no to things.
Absolutely. And Teresa, does Amazon take on mature age candidates who have decided to, you know, change their career, go back to uni and are interested in a role? Or do you really look for that prior experience? Like, yeah, that's a question I often get asked. So
Yeah. This is a definite yes, you know, and I personally say kudos to you to you really make that decision, you know, to go back to uni and learn like a completely different degree or diploma and then re-enter the workforce. You know, you bring so much experience, you know, from transferable skills, but also, you know, curiosity, you know, to have an aptitude to learn something new. So we definitely encourage, you know, mature age, you know, applicants to apply through for our roles here.
Thanks, Teresa. I mean, I'm not sure what your class is mature age, but 100%, I myself have, you know, had a career switch quite early on, actually, after uni. I graduated from a commerce law degree and very quickly, you know, decided that law wasn't for me. I was a lawyer for only about a year and then made the switch to tech. So absolutely have a go. And as you say, kudos to you going back to uni. That's incredible. Teresa, to round up this interview, do you think that a cover letter is actually required when making an application? I can't remember back when I, you know, handed in my CV 4.5 years ago if I had a cover letter, but it is a question that I actually want to know the answer to. Is it important, or can you still get a job without a cover letter these days?
Yeah, it definitely does not hurt to have one, you know, but you can also do a short blurb highlighting the key points in your resume as well. So depending on your role, if you are going for a more senior role, you know, definitely a cover letter shows, you know, that motivation and interest. If you are going for more of the entry level or more of a junior role, sometimes the number of applications that we do see through as recruiters, we don't even look at the cover letter, to be completely honest. And so when you want to highlight, you know, your key highlights, it's definitely better to add that, you know, on your resume. Any employer would definitely see value of you taking that time when you're submitting, you know, your application. So in saying that, make sure though, you know, don't copy and paste, and, you know, make sure that, you know, when you're doing that, put the right company, as often I see candidates addressing to a different company altogether. So without, you know, that attention to detail. So a cover letter of one page is enough, you know, just to kind of highlight your motivation and key strengths.
Teresa, when you see something like that, like for instance, the wrong company name, is that just an automatic like no? Or do you still consider that candidate if they've got a stellar CV? Like I'm actually really interested in that one.
Yeah, definitely. So, you know, depending on the role itself, you know, I would definitely call the candidate and, you know, really question them up on you know, that. But, you know, often we do make mistakes as well. But, you know, as I said, you know, attention to detail is key when you are, you know, applying through for multiple roles. Definitely doesn't put you in the right foot, you know, to begin with.
Oh, goodness. All right. Well, Teresa, thank you so much for the tips. We'll get you back next week for some more tips. So thank you so much. If anyone has any questions, please pop them in the comment section below and we'll get back to you. Thank you so much.
Amazing. Thank you.